Waldeck from Prudential Financial. I'd be interested in the Prime Minister's thoughts on Turkey's policies to combat the threat of ISIS and under what circumstances Turkey would consider using ground troops to combat ISIS.
Can you also, in your answer to that, also add a little bit about what more you could do to stop the flow of recruits from around the world transiting Turkey to beef up ISIS?
First of all, let us clarify this group ISIS. How did they emerge? ISIS did come to the picture of Syrian scene in 2013, March. Means after 2 years of Syrian crisis. And in that 2 years, around 200,000 people were killed. So, and millions were already refugees. So there is now, we are very short mind, short memory we have. There is an impression now, as if Syrian crisis is ISIL crisis. If you eliminate ISIL, there will be no Syrian crisis. This is not true. ISIL did emerge after 2 years of Syrian crisis. Even if you eliminate ISIL today, which we have to do, we have to fight and we have to eliminate, another radical group may emerge with not ISIL, but PISIL or IKIL, whatever it is, based on the same, in the same context. Where did they come from? Not from Turkey. Some people are propagating this as if there is a transit to ISIL from Turkey. No. ISIL before was Iraqi Islamic State, IIL, which was formed in 2003 by another Baghdadi linked to Al-Qaeda. And this Baghdadi, the terrorist, the leader of this terrorist group, was in Abu Ghraib prison under the control of when U.S. forces are there. And stayed there until after the withdrawal of American troops. And they came from Iraqi territories to Syria. They entered Syria from Iraq. And when they entered, Syrian regime didn't do anything against them. In fact, some of them were released from Syrian prisons. Because we have intelligence experience. I was mediating between Iraq and Syria in 2009 when Maliki accused Bashar Assad to organize terrorist attacks in Baghdad. Syrian regime had contacts with this group. From 2013 March until 2014 June, until they attacked Mosul, there was no single clash between the Syrian regime and Daesh and the ISIL. ISIL controlled Deir ez-Zor, which was under the control of Free Syrian Army, then took over Raqqa, which was under the control of Free Syrian Army, moderate opposition, then Minbij, then Jarablus. How did they control? Because Syrian airstrikes, air forces, bombarded these places, and moderate Syrian forces, Free Syrian Army, had to evacuate. And ISIL came in. So there was a tactical coalition between regime and ISIL. When did this change? When they attacked back to Mosul. Until that time, ISIL was not in the agenda of Iraqi or Syrian regime. Syrian regime especially. Now, there is such a threat. What should be done? We have to do everything to prevent them. There is no other country more threatened than Turkey because of this ISIL, because we have 1,295 kilometer long Iraq and Syria border, and 60% of this border is under ISIL control. We cannot tolerate this. But what is the method? How will we do it? The method is we have to have a grand integrated strategy for Syria and for Iraq, but especially for Syria. In Syria, the job is more difficult for us because there is no counterpart in Baghdad, in Damascus. In Baghdad, at least we have a counterpart. We can work together. Our Minister of Defense was in Baghdad yesterday and today in Erbil, and we sent two full of equipment to airplane to Baghdad. And we are training Peshmerga. Turkish forces are training Peshmerga and also Muslim people in order to liberate Mosul. But in Syria, with whom will you work? This is the question. We have been asking this question, and for the last 4 years, we have been telling to American friends, European friends, that moderate forces should be supported. There was no support to moderate forces. Because of this power vacuum, they took over the control. When did they become a real threat as an army, as if they are army, this ISIL? When they took over sophisticated American weapons in Mosul, which were left by Iraqi army back. Tanks, armored vehicles, heavy weapons of Iraqi army were taken by ISIL. Until that time, ISIL was the balance of power between Free Syrian Army and ISIL was almost equal because of light weapons. But ISIL took these weapons. Many of them are American weapons. Of course, I don't blame United States because they gave this to Iraqi army. And Iraqi army left them in a few hours. They evacuated Mosul and they took all these arms. Where is Turkey in this picture? We are victim of all this struggle. 2 million people. Because of Kobani issue, 200,000 Kurds came to Turkish side in 3 days. We received 200,000 Kurds escaping from Kobani. If we didn't receive them, they would have been massacred. We allowed Peshmergas to go to Kobani. We allowed Free Syrian Army to go to Kobani. Still, international media give an impression as if people are being killed in Syria because Turkey is not willing to make ground operation. Why we should do ground operation? Why Turkey should take risk if there is no grand strategy accepted by all? If American, European, or other ground troops are not there, why Turkey should send? Yes, one day we can send it, as last week we sent 600 military personnel, 40 tanks, 100 vehicles, to make an operation 40 kilometers deep inside in Syrian territory to take our military and our territory to relocate a holy place, a holy tomb of the ancestor of Ottoman, founder of Ottoman state. And it was a very successful operation. I was in the headquarters of our army from 9 o'clock in the evening until 6 o'clock. We ran the operation. It was a very successful operation because it was a threat to Turkish national security. If there is a threat, of course, we will take action. Today there is a threat, big threat, but threat to all of us. And we need to have a concerted action together. What Turkey wants? First, equip and train moderate forces. Why? Because today Syrian people, innocent Syrian people, are being sandwiched by two brutal sides.
But that will take years to get these people equipped and trained.
It would have been much easier if it started 4 years ago. But unfortunately, our European and American colleagues, they were reluctant. They just observed. We, in every meeting as Minister of Foreign Affairs, I warned our colleagues that it is if we do not train and equip moderate forces, there will be radicalization and there will be brutality of the regime. This still it is possible because on the ground there are around 60 to 70,000 moderate forces, I can say, which can change the balance of power. This is something important because putting two options to the Syrian people is not fair. Either a radical, brutal terrorist group or a brutal regime. This is a very bad choice. We should not be legitimizing Assad because of the threat of ISIL. Assad is responsible for all what happened in Syria. Syrian people, we know them very well, they were not radical or they were not Wahhabi or this type of extremist ideology. They are much like Turkish people, more moderate. This happened because of these brutal attacks. First, equip and train. Second, safe haven. Safe haven for refugees. Enough is enough. Turkey paid $5 billion only for the Syrians living in our camps. You can imagine the rest are in the cities, which are much, much more costly. Third, air exclusion zone or no-fly zone. Because if we do not do it today, if Free Syrian Army attacks ISIL, Syrian regime will control Aleppo. Why Free Syrian Army is not fighting against ISIL? Because if they move from Aleppo to Raqqa to fight against ISIL, Syrian regime will bombard Aleppo and will take Aleppo. And for moderate forces, Aleppo is the most important place to defend. Therefore, they had to come to Aleppo to be withdrawing from ISIL. These are some elements of our strategy. We are ready to contribute. We are contributing. We are helping. Equip and train agreement between Turkey and U.S. is a historic step. We will do even more, much more. But we want to see the end of the tunnel, the light at the end of the tunnel. Now, in a darkness of tunnel, it is difficult to make to see the final phase of this struggle. But I can say this coalition, our coalition, now there are more practical discussions, consultations, and we hope that we will work very closely against this terrorist threat. About the transit, whether Turkey, this is also a myth.
It's a myth.
It's a myth. I will give you. Not myth. I don't mean that it is not. There is no transit from Turkey. I don't mean that. Oh. But not from Turkey only. From Iraq, from other neighboring countries, and from Turkey, how can we prevent it? I will give you a striking example. 1.5 years ago, one European colleague of mine told me, Ahmet, can you prevent these people to go there? We are taking all the measures, I told him. But Turkey receives 35 million tourists every year. We cannot decide who is terrorist, who is not, looking at their face. So let us please prevent these people to leave your country. I don't want to give the name of the country. Prevent them to leave the country. He said, but we are a democratic country. We cannot prevent anyone to go outside the country if they didn't commit any crime yet. I said, okay, I understand. Please give us the name of those suspects so that we will not allow them to come in Turkey. He said, how can we give the name of individuals who didn't commit any crime until yet? We are a democratic country. And I told him, we are a democratic country as well. How can we arrest someone coming to Turkey without knowing him or her and without having any intelligence report from you? Then they start to give the names. And in last 1 year, 10,000 people were not allowed to come in Turkey from the airport. When we received the list, we said, okay, we don't accept you to Turkey. And around 2,000 of them were deported after they came in Turkey. 911 kilometer long border. You, American friends and administration, they know very well how it is difficult to protect American-Mexican border. Despite of the fact that there is a Mexican government on the other side, a well-functioning state, it is difficult to prevent, stop all illegal migration. 2 million means total population of Atlanta, Chicago, and several American cities. We could do it. Another reason why it is difficult to both sides. Tomorrow, we can close all the border and put soldiers everywhere. But then nobody will ask us to receive refugees anymore. Refugees are coming. We cannot check whether they are this group or that group. And this, we implement open door policy based on humanitarian ground. And if you implement open door policy, it is difficult to close all the borders. Because in one fighting, hundreds of them are coming towards Turkey. Next day, another hundreds want to go back to Syria when they feel that it is secure. So it is not so easy job, but we are doing everything possible. And we are against foreign fighters, but let me say one another just to compare. Yes, all of us, we are against foreign fighter. But do we do enough against the presence of Hezbollah, who are foreign fighters coming from Lebanon, supporting regime? Do we do enough who come from Iraq, Asaibul Haq, supporting regime? Do we do enough that some countries are sending officials to fight in Syria? But when it comes to one side, as if there are only those are the only foreign fighters, this is also misleading. We have to be principle-oriented. Turkey has suffered from terrorism in the last three decades. We never tolerate any terrorism. Radicalization in Islam, we are against it because our way of Islam is not their way of Islam. Turkish way of Islam is multiculturalist, tolerance, harmonious. And why didn't we have Al-Qaeda in Turkey very strong? We have some small groups maybe. Because Turkish culture is a urban Islam culture. And in that cultural atmosphere, it is difficult to find such a ground. And it is a threat, ideological threat to us, because their presence is against our presence as Islam. It is a security threat to us, but it depends how we will be dealing with them. What we say is, see Syria and Iraq as a macro picture and develop a strategy, one by one, and we should know what will be happening next day after we fight or we do any operation against Daesh, against ISIL. Then it will be much easier to consult and to make proper planning.